Hello everyone, today I would like to present to you the full version of Theorem Earth UK analyst. Obviously, when we released the Theorem Earth clip 1 month ago as one of our first clips, it was quite short and did not cover so many information. Later, when we released the other use case, which are quite comprehensive, I was asked by many if I can do the same for Theorem Earth, then here we go. First of all, let's go quickly to the problem statement that the case study is really long and on high level. No time for you during the exam to read and analyze. So what we're going to do, we will modeling the architect diagram, highlight the most important area, and also share with you the reference architect of IoT, Internet of Things. First of all, Theorem Earth is really good representative for IoT, Internet of Things, where data from plenty device got collected for different purpose. Internet of Things refer to the system of interrelated internet-connected objects that are able to collect and transfer the data over the wireless network without human intervention. And here is some example for the information type. It could be device metadata like an identifier that uniquely identifies a device. It can be the state information, the current state of the device, whether the machine is now working or not. And this data is usually not changed frequently. Telemetry, the data about the environment and usually got collected through the sensor of the machine and it got updated frequently. Further information type you can find in cloud.google.com Architect IoT Overview. So there are further two things that you also should know about the IoT. That the world of IoT just gets started. A lot of new things needs to discover. Further, after your IoT project is up and running, many devices will produce a lot of data. So when it comes to storing, processing, and analyzing data, especially big data, it had to be the cloud. Now, let us review Theorem Earth SE diagram. For company overview, Theorem Earth manufacture heavy equipment, and currently they have 500 dealer and service center in 100 country. And their mission is to build this system to make the customer, meaning the dealer and the service center, more productive. Moving to solution concept, there are 2 million vehicles with a sensor in operation at the moment, and they expect 20% of growth per year. The vehicle will collect the telemetry data from many sensors during operation, and the small subset of the critical data will be transmitted in real time to facilitate the fleet management, so it should be the state and the operation data. Stream real-time means the vehicle has direct connection to internet through mobile connection. They have the meaning to choose the suitable ingestion data technology later on. The rest of the sensor data is collected, compressed, and uploaded daily when the vehicle returns to home base. And its vehicle expect to generate 200 to 500 megabyte data per day. So if you multiply with 2 million vehicles, it will give you 400 terabyte to 1 petabyte per day. So it's a huge data, and we later need to plan how for data transfer. For more information, you can also refer to the clip about data transfer to Google Cloud below. Now, let us take a look how the data got ingested, processed, and stored with the current existing environment. Theorem Earth vehicle data aggregation and analysis infrastructure reside already in Google Cloud to serve the client from around the world. Talking about data aggregation, it could be data flow and data analysis would be BigQuery. Further, a growing amount of sensor data is captured from their two main manufacturing plants and sent to private data centers that contain their legacy inventory and logistic management. With these two sentences, it gives us the indication that data processing and analysis already play in GCP where data ingestion and storage is still on-prem. Therefore, the hybrid connection before the migration complete is required. And here they are. The private data center have multiple network interconnects configured to Google Cloud. The web front end for the dealer and customer is running on Google Cloud and allow the access to stock management analysts. The web front end can be performed in App Engine or Kubernetes depend on the real requirement. Let us move to the business and technical requirement to see how the architect diagram got transformed. Number one, predict and detect the vehicle malfunction and rapidly ship part to the dealership for just-in-time repair where possible. Based on the state and operation data, to detect the vehicle malfunction, we need the use of BigQuery. While to predict the malfunction, we need the machine learning and TensorFlow would be one example. We also need to optimize the machine learning prediction and the BigQuery analytic here in order to get just-in-time repair. 2. Decrease cloud operational cost and adapt to seasonality. For operational cost reduction, we can use the managed service or own the product that we just mentioned here. Besides, we can use the cloud monitoring with the cost analysis in the BigQuery or primitive tie a VM where possible to reduce the operational cost. To adapt to seasonality, this means that there are some months during the year where the vehicles are highly used compared to the other month, and for that reason, the data processing is also higher. And this requires the auto scale feature for automatically adapt to seasonality. 3, 4, 5 are grouped together because they are related to the development and deployment process. For 3, increase speed and reliability of development workflow. So it requires the highly scaled environment to speed the automation CI/CD pipeline, reliability to test and deployment strategy. 4, allow remote developer to productive without compromising code or data security. It requires the identification, authentication, authorization of the remote developer with the cloud identity and cloud IAM and also the secure remote connection. 5, create the flexible and scalable platform for developer to create custom API service for dealer and partner. A cloud new build flexible and scalable API platform is needed and is highly scaled environment and mentioned above. This is a new build on top of GCP to specific to this company. Technical requirement. Number one, create a new abstraction layer for HTTP API access to their legacy system to enable the gradual move into cloud without disrupting operation. So APG could be a good candidate. 2, modelize own CI/CD pipeline to allow developer to deploy container-based workload in highly scalable environment. Container-based workloads, so the API could be built on GKE or Cloud Run, which also fit to the other business requirement on reduction of the operational cost and highly scalable. For CI/CD, it can contain GCP Cloud Source Repository to store and manage the version of the source code, Cloud Build to build the code, the Cloud Container Registry to store container image, Jenkins or Spinnaker also the good candidate for automation deployment pipeline. 3. Allow developer to run experiment without compromising security and government requirement. So we can think about the security code scan, encrypt the code, separate environment for different purpose like dev, test and production and as well as the right approval process. 4. Create new self-service portal for internal and partner developer to create new project, request resource for data analytics job, and centrally manage the access to API endpoint. So here, the self-service portal also can be based on the application engine or Kubernetes engine, depend on, of course, the detail of the requirement and put on top of the API platform. 5. build cloud-native solution for key and secret management and optimize for identity-based access. So KMS should be the product that we choose. It's used for service account key, encryption key, and GKE secret. 6. Improve and standardize tools necessary for application and network monitoring and troubleshooting. This refers to stack driver that we already mentioned above. Moving to executive statement, there is a desire to move the remaining legacy system to cloud. If you remember, in the SE analysis, we already understand that the current data center on-prem holding two functions. Number one is for data ingestion, including stream and batch data ingestion. Second is data storage. So if we want to decommission data center on-prem, then we have to transfer these two functions into GCP. For IoT streaming, GCP provides the IoT core, which is fully managed service for managing device. This includes the registration, authentication, the authorization inside Google Cloud Resource Hierarchy, as well as the device metadata stored in cloud, and the ability to send the device configuration from the service to the device. For storage, depending on the type of data and the purpose of using it, there will be different products which could be suitable. Here is two examples, cloud storage for unstructured data and Bigtable for the timing data. Finally, this is the target architecture of Terraform Earth, where you do not see the on-prem data center anymore because the data from 2 million vehicles with the sensor will be streamed directly to the core IoT of GCP or send edge bus daily to the storage of Google. It could be Bigtable for timing data or cloud storage. The data from these two areas, core IoT or cloud storage, will be sent to data flow for data enrichment. Both this even come to BigQuery for data analytics or machine learning for further prediction. The result would be finally activated and presented in the web funnel for the dealer. So now I would like to share with you one example of build and train machine learning in cloud. So here we have different device that going to send the data to the gateway. Vice versa, a gateway will send the control back to the device, telling the device to do this, to do that. A gateway will enable the device that are not directly connected to the internet to reach to cloud service. And you can see an application logic is built on top of the TensorFlow and the other connection agent. Between gateway device and cloud service, they are also maintain a connection like this. For those device that connect to Google Cloud directly, they will send the data to the IoT core that I already mentioned above. And from IoT core, the data will be sent to data analytics and machine learning. How in detail? First of all, IoT core will ingest the data to PubSub. From PubSub, the data will be sent to data flow for data enrichment. From there, the data will be sent to Cloud Bigtable for storing timing data or to BigQuery for data analysis and then to AI platform for machine learning, and from there, further prediction can be built. The result will later will be presented in different platforms like Data Lab or Data Studio, which can be integrated in different interface for the client. And here is the reference architect of the use case Terraform Earth. So here you can see different vehicle going to send the data to Google Cloud Platform, and it will be different module. Number one, vehicle device management. Three smaller modules sitting inside cloud IoT core, device manager, device control, and device authentication service. Second, vehicle data ingestion. First of all, data will be sent to MQTT protocol bridge or message queue telemetry transport broker sitting inside cloud IoT core. Then it will be ingested to cloud PubSub and then sent to cloud data flow for data enrichment. Furthermore, number three, data storage, based on the type of data, whether it could be unstructured, then cloud storage could be the good candidate, or timing data, Bigtable. Data analysis, Data can be enriched again using cloud data flow, could be analyzed using BigQuery or doing the machine learning for further prediction. Then the data we got stored in cloud storage Bigtable or could be the result from the analytic can be presented now in the front end and integration service, which we can use different compute engine like Kubernetes, App Engine or VM. And the data finally will be presented in the front end of mobile web or apps. For those that data need to present in on-prem data center, then a connection secure like Cloud VPN or interconnect could be required. And here are two links that I should present to you: build and train machine learning in cloud and reference architect for Terraform Earth use case. These two links are also available in the description of this video. So I just finished presenting to you the Terraform Earth full analysis use case. I hope it's useful to you, especially to the one I'm now preparing for the exam. So if you feel like it's helpful, please like, share, and subscribe to our channel. We are working with the further clip and share with you soon. Thank you.